A Canticle for Leibowitz. Part 1 of a series in 15 parts. Adapted from a novel by Walter Miller Jr. A Canticle for Leibowitz. Here begins the chronicle, made and kept, each in his generation, by the monks of Blessed Isaac Edward Leibowitz, in their abbey in the desert of the southwest. Now it came to pass that mankind, as in the time of Noah, was swollen with pride. And the wise men of that age, among them Blessed Leibowitz, placed great engines of war in the hands of princes. And the princes thought, each to himself, if I but strike swiftly enough and in secret, I shall destroy those others in their sleep, and there will be none to fight back. The earth shall be mine. Such was the folly of princes. And there followed the flame deluge. Nations vanished from the earth. Great clouds of wrath engulfed the forests and fields. And in those places of the earth where men still lived, all were sickened by the poisoned air, so that while some escaped death, none was left untouched. In all parts of the world, much wrath was kindled against the princes and the magi who devised the weapons. And the wrathful said, "Let us stone and disembowel and burn the ones who did this thing, together with their hirelings and their wise men. Burning let them perish, and all their works, their names, and even their memories. Let us make a great simplification, and then the world shall begin again." And so it was, that after the flame deluge and the fallout, there began the bloodletting of the simplification. And there perished in it rulers over empires and kingdoms, men of authority and wisdom, teachers of skills and sorceries, yea, even artisans. For the people were greatly wroth that the place of their habitation was become a slaughterhouse and a wasteland and a breeding ground of monsters. And they said, "Let those who have dealt this destruction themselves be destroyed." And so it was. But there were some that perished not, that fled for sanctuary to Holy Church. And among them there survived our founder, the Blessed Leibowitz. And this was in the days before he entered religion, who, while he was yet in the world, was wedded to a wife whose name was Emily. And by mischance she was not with him on the day of the flame deluge. Accordingly, thereafter, he searched for her, long and zealously, but he found her not, neither alive nor dead. So he entered religion as a monk, and was ordained priest. And many years passed, and in the fullness of time he searched his heart, and it seemed good to him that there should be instituted a new community of religious, given over to the preservation of learning. And he sent messages to New Rome, for old Rome was a heap of ashes and a desolation. And New Rome gave answer, and said yes. So a monastery was builded in the desert of the southwest. And the brethren were robed in a habit made of burlap. And they were sent forth across the land, charged to bring back to the abbey, secretly, whatever books there might yet be that had escaped burning. And other brethren there were who were charged with burying the books in great sealed casks, lest they be found and destroyed by vandals. And these same brethren were charged also to learn the books by rote, that the words might live, even though the books themselves be found and destroyed. And these brethren were called memorizers. Now it came to pass that our blessed founder, himself journeying as a booklegger, fell into an ambush. For he was betrayed by a traitor artisan, known to him, who gave out, alas truly, that Leibowitz was not only a man of learning, skilled to read, but more, a maker and deviser of the great engines of war. This Judas our founder swiftly forgave. But the multitude, not so forgiving, gave our founder over to death. nay to two deaths in one. For some would that he were burned, others that he were hanged. So not to make great divisions thereupon, they strangled him in a noose depending over a fire. Thus came our blessed Leibowitz to his martyrdom. And since that day, 6 centuries have passed. Nor in that time hath the world changed its ways, for there is still a great darkness abroad, and only within Holy Church doth the light of learning yet shine, and that chiefly here, in this abbey, for here alone do the words of the ancient wisdom live on. We do not comprehend them, yet we do preserve them. Nor shall we ever forsake that duty, for this is our charge, that these, our memorabilia, endure, to live on into a new age of light. Yea, even though the darkness in the world last 10 more centuries, or even 10,000 years. For we, though born in the darkest of ages, are still the very bookleggers and memorizers of the Beatus Leibowitz.
On the horizon, a small figure, wiggling in a shimmering haze of heat. It suggested a tiny apparition spawned by the heat demons who tortured the land. It was growing out of the mirror glaze on the broken roadway. It was coming toward him.
Oh, no.
He clutched at his rosary. At high noon, desert creatures lay motionless in burrows, or hid beneath rocks from the ferocity of the sun and the heat of the wind. Only a thing monstrous, a thing with addled wits, would hike down the trail at noon